G'day everyone, it's Clayton from Planet Canada here. And today we're going to talk about one of my favorite tools in Cabinet Vision, the xShaping module, which gives you and me as the designer or engineer, the ability to draw and design very complex forms ahead of our CNC optimizing and real world construction. There really isn't any shape, any cabinet, any reception desk, any task that is going to be too complicated thanks to this nifty little tool. So let's see how to use it and some of the advantages in adding it to your program. I've drawn up several cabinets for us to test on, and immediately we're going to see how the xShaping tool gives us the ability to very simply add and modify operations on our parts. Like we can add holes, dados, cutouts, really whatever we need to get the job done. On my upper cabinet here, I'm going to add a cutout in the bottom. Maybe like I would want to make space for a range hood. So I'm going to click twice on my upper cabinet, which is going to take me to my cabinet properties. It's useful that I'm off from the plan view. And now I'm going to click on the part that I would like to add the operation to. So in this case, we want to add the bottom. So once I've clicked on that, I'm going to click twice again, and I'll be taken to the part properties. You can see at the top here, I've got a whole variety of tools that will allow me to add different operations to my parts. In this case, if we wanted to add an operation to the bottom for a cutout, a range hood cutout, I could just click on the rectangle tool and I could draw a rectangle onto my part. Now, I haven't measured this to make sure it's the right dimensions or the right spacing from the front and the back. But once I've added that operation, I could always click select, use the select tool to click on the part. And you'll see on the left-hand side here, it's where I can change anything from the width, the length, the depth, the angle of the cut. I can even specify which tool I would like to do this operation, or the line that I would like the cutout to be on, whether it's the center line, the left-hand side, or the right-hand side. So that's a very easy way to add a cutout to our parts. We can also use these other tools to add different operations. We can add dados, we can add holes, and it's so simple to do. I can just start clicking on my part, and I can make sure I'm placing them where I would really want to in real life. But you can see that just with the click of the button, I've already got these operations there, and I can continue on with my project and my design. The xShaping tool also gives us the ability to modify the forms and shapes of parts in a very detailed way. So for instance, if we went to our base cabinet now, sometimes we might like to add notches to the backs of our ends. Perhaps we're making space for plumbing or electrical. So if we wanted to adjust the size of these parts, or the form of these parts, we can find the end perhaps that we want to adjust, click on it. And in this case, I can now click right click on the finished end, and I can choose the edit shape feature. Here with the edit shape feature, I could change the shape of my end. So let's say I added, if I wanted to add a little notch here, I could add the notch in. I can use the select tool to, or the trim tool to remove any additional lines so that we've got a nice clean form. And then if I click on the check tool, it will just go all green to tell me it's all good to go. I can click return and save. And just like that, I can now add a notch to my cabinet. xShaping also gives us the ability to make these adjustments not only to the parts but to our cabinets as a whole, which means we can now construct very complex or very unusual shaped cabinets with just a click of a button. So if I click return and go back to the elevation, let's go to the plan view, and maybe I'll grab this cabinet here and place them against the wall. If I want to, I can use the xShaping feature to drastically change this cabinet, and then Cabinet Vision will very intelligently reconstruct this cabinet so that it follows our preset construction methods. So if I click on Edit Shape, you'll see that I've got a lot of the similar tools at the top here. If I wanted to, I could create an unusual shape like so and like so. And then I can trim off the excess lines so that I've got a strong shape like that. And then if I click check, yep, it's all good, and return, you'll see that Cabinet Vision will now reconstruct this cabinet to make this unusual shape. If we go to the 3D2, we can see exactly what I mean. And then from then on, it could just be a matter of us adding in the right panels to the right faces or the doors or whatever we want to add. This xShaping feature also gives us the ability to very easily add curves to our cabinets, perhaps if we're drawing a reception desk. So to see that, let's copy this cabinet here. And then if I wanted to, I can click on the edit shape and using the bend tool or the offset tool, maybe we'll go the bend tool. I can bend my part like that and then go the offset. I could create an offset like so and then connect these parts. And then check that, yeah. And then Cabinet Vision will construct this unusual round shape, just like so. We can see if we go to the 3D, and voila, I've got this cabinet with an unusual curve all drawn up. It took me just several seconds, and then from here, I can go into the cabinet properties and adjust little things I might like to tweak, like this, the spaces, the stretches, anything like that. So you can see with just a few clicks, as a Cabinet Vision user, I can very easily modify my parts or cabinets as a whole or right down to the minutiae. Being able to control every single operation or shape of my part drastically minimizes the amount of time I spend in fine-tuning those important details. And then when the parts are cut on our CNC with these necessary operations pre-programmed, we also help minimize the amount of time spent in the factory and create a more efficient workplace.
Hey, thanks so much for watching. If you'd like to see more tutorials like this one, please be sure to like and subscribe. You can also check out our other videos that will help guide you on your path to becoming a Cabinet Vision Power user.